Hello, everybody. Welcome to Stratoscale Hybrid DevOps Pros. I'm Ariel, and with me is Liaz.
Hi, Ariel.
Today, we're going to talk about Kubernetes on Symphony 4.2.6. And let's start about deployment Kubernetes with VPCs and Terraform.
Mm-hmm. So Kubernetes is a huge feature in our product, and also AWS. And this video will combine both of them. We'll show how easy it is to create a VPC, that will be the infrastructure, and then we'll create a Kubernetes embedded into that VPC. That Kubernetes will be totally isolated in that VPC network, and will use all the features of AWS API and VPC and Terraform to create an isolated Kubernetes.
Fantastic. Cluster. Let's start deploying a Kubernetes cluster.
Let's do that. So first thing we'll do, we'll start with the infrastructure. That's the Terraform. I have here my Terraform, my code. It will deploy a VPC and isolated network together with all kinds of DHCP options in order to access to the Docker Hub. This is where that's where the container will be hosted. Let's look at the network overview.
So while you're deploying a VPC using Terraform, what are the benefits of deploying a Kubernetes cluster inside of a VPC?
Okay, so first of all, once you're working with VPC, you're in the AWS API ecosystem and be able to use any kind of infrastructure as code tool that supports AWS API. Second of all, you're using all the security features you have in AWS API in order to isolate your Kubernetes cluster and protect it. You're using security group, using specific routes, and so on and so forth.
So effectively, I have my private Kubernetes cluster isolated from the rest of the environment, running inside of a VPC.
Yes, and when you say you have your own, that means that's actually my own. I'm using the tenancy feature inside Symphony. Each one of the members can have its own Kubernetes cluster, and I can create my own cluster, and then I can share it with you. There is no one big Kubernetes cluster with.
So when we have multiple teams trying to collaborate using containers and then orchestrating them with Kubernetes, what we're seeing here is the ability to provide to each team their own private Kubernetes cluster. So there's no interference between the teams, right?
Mm-hmm.
And beyond that, I think probably adds a lot more security in production environments where everybody is isolated through network isolation, running in a private VPC environment. It's not a one big party Kubernetes cluster?
No.
Okay, fantastic.
No, if I'm a developer and I have the production Kubernetes, I want to be ready, so I'll create my own Kubernetes cluster, make sure everything works, and then I'll deploy.
So that's actually how it works in the public cloud, right? Isn't
mm-hmm.
that how the Kubernetes services from AWS and from Google and from Azure operate?
This is exactly how it goes. They're using their old tenancy. I have my account.
Wonderful.
Each user has its own account and is doing that. Okay. So I have my, just to show you, VPC is created using infrastructure as code. I have here my unique Symphony VPC topology. You see an AWS API. That's the subnet. That's the route table. This is the VPC. So let's go ahead and create the cluster.
Yeah, let's create a Kubernetes cluster.
It's super easy. So we'll create a Kubernetes 1.8.1. That's the engine I'll be using. By the way, the administrator is managing the engines for me.
I see. So actually in a deployment, I could have a mix of different Kubernetes engines according to what my admin is allowing me to do.
Yes. And I'm using VPCs. As you can see here, Kubernetes in Symphony is not implemented above Symphony. It is embedded inside Symphony. So all the features that Symphony has to offer when it comes to APIs, storage, so on and so forth, is embedded inside.
So
you can see that in the UI.
First class citizen.
Yes.
As a service.
Yes, yes.
Fantastic.
So everything is embedded, so I can choose the VPC, the Elastic API, and here I can, by the way, choose whatever pool, whatever storage pool I want my Kubernetes to run on.
Interesting. So when we have different volume types that are mapped to different storage tiers, whether high performance mm-hmm. or low cost, we can map those volume types into our Kubernetes cluster mm-hmm. and take advantage of that.
Yes. So if I want to run my Kubernetes test cluster, because I'm a smart and responsible developer, I will use maybe the HDD and the cheap storage, which is okay for testing, and then production can run on the flash
drives. On flash drives.
Yes.
That's great.
Let's start with two nodes, Kubernetes. And this is the instance type.
Okay, let's T2 large instances.
That's it.
Oh, that looks very easy.
Very easy.
So how long does it take to provision a Kubernetes cluster?
Several minutes, start to end. That means it includes the virtual machines. It includes all the configuration inside, health checks. That simply
So Symphony is taking care of the lifecycle management and creating a Kubernetes cluster for
yes.
me. And as a user, the only thing I care about is, what, I assume that Kubernetes endpoint that I can use my trusted kube control on?
Yes. So all you care about, how can I access the Kubernetes? And we'll see that in a second. Let's go inside the Kubernetes itself. So all you care about is the health of your cluster and some of the application specific that you want to run on. And again, how can I access it, the connectivity? Basically, the point is that you care about your business logic and everything which is not business value.
So all the undifferentiated heavy lifting that I need in order to be able to use Kubernetes is being taken care of by Symphony.
Yes.
So now I think it's deploying the first node out of two.
That's the good events. Yes, it deploys the master.
Provisioning the capacity, deploying the master node, yes. and then I assume later on it's going to deploy the worker nodes.
Yes.
And I'm going to have...
Yeah, so if we can, we can go to the network overview, see what's going on there, because I promised you that it's going to run on top of the VPC, so I'll filter it to the Kubernetes. And you can see here that first node connected.
Oh, the first node is connected.
Yeah, connected already in the VPC. And just like you said, it inherited the security groups I defined in my Terraform. It inherited the routing tables and so on. So I defined everything in the Terraform and just started the Kubernetes.
Fantastic. So I have a VPC environment that's isolating my Kubernetes cluster using identity management, storage management, network management, compute instances are being provided by the platform, and I can just deploy.
Yes.
That's so easy.
It's very important to emphasize that everything I do here in the UI is basically API based. So you can script it using Bash. We have a very elaborated Python client. You're free to use whatever you want.
That's fantastic.
Let's go back to the cluster. So it is still creating. Okay, it's configured. Once the cluster is up, we'll be able to access the Kubernetes API and the Kubernetes UI. And if you want to use the UI, free to do so. I personally will use the kubectl.
Fantastic. So actually, after provisioning the master node, the platform can provision, I think, something like 5 at a time, the worker nodes, so you can actually scale quite quickly.
Yeah.
That's nice to see. Okay, let's give it a couple minutes to load and see where it goes.
Yeah, so as soon as the master node is up, the cluster will be up and running, and we'll be able to go in and see exactly what it does, and the other nodes are just like you said. Okay, there you go.
And now it's spawning
the second
node.
Yeah, so now it's configured.
Node.
Yeah, so you can see that all the services are already up, and same goes for deployments and pods that are internally used by Kubernetes. So they're some of them are running, some of them are actually still
being
pending.
Deployed, yeah.
The events, and we're already spawning the first worker. Okay, so it's active. And by the way, that's the status of the Symphony virtual machine that we'll be hosting.
It's the instance.
Yes, that's right. And if I go again to the network overview, again, filter that VPC. There you go.
Okay, now we're saying those two nodes in my Kubernetes cluster. Mm-hmm.
And same like the master, it inherited all the security features that you implemented in the Terraform.
Got it. So using security groups to isolate.
Yes.
And micro-segment the cluster.
Right, so now the cluster is created and it's actually now in the state of provisioning. So I have a cluster, I can provision. Let's see if the Kubernetes UI service is already up and running. All you need to do is click that button and you're immediately directed into the Kubernetes UI. There you go. Let me just skip the security feature, which you can free to use.
Oh, beautiful.
Yes.
So here we're still seeing just one node. Mm-hmm. I assume that the second node is going to join in a second.
Yes.
Great.
So that's the master node. If you're comfortable with working with the Kubernetes UI, free to do so by clicking.
So Stratoscale is providing a managed Kubernetes service that is actually using upstream Kubernetes with no modification and the undifferentiated heavy lifting of provisioning, maintaining, managing, scaling, tearing up, tearing down of the Kubernetes clusters is being provided by the platform. And I think we're going to see a lot more of that in a minute.
So once it's done provisioning, it will go actually into a degraded state. Degraded means I still did not go through all the health checks. So from my point of view, this cluster is degraded. It will go through the health checks, and then it will be running.
I see. So whenever we add another node to the cluster, it's going to go through the extensive health checks before it gets admitted fully.
That's one of the features and the whole points of having managed Kubernetes.
Perfect.
There it is. It is
so
degraded.
Now we have two nodes. The cluster is degraded.
Yes.
And
also in the events, you can see that it went from provisioning into degraded. Behind the scenes, there are all kinds of health checks going right now. And it will soon be, by the way, if I go to the Kubernetes from Kubernetes point of view, you'll soon see that it will point into two nodes.
Yep. Here's my second node.
Yes. So there it is.
Okay.
It is running.
Okay. So health checks done. The cluster is up and running. Fantastic.
This is it for deployment. This is how easy it is.
Very easy. So now we've seen how we can deploy a Kubernetes cluster using Terraform and VPCs on Symphony 4.2.6. Great.
Thank you, Ariel.